disturbances with the public address system. First of all, a formal welcome to all the delegates from almost 50 countries around the world who are assembled here in Chile. Thanks to the massive efforts undertaken by ATTACH, the team based in Chile, and the Telecentro de Paz Foundation team based in Manila. This is possible. So my special word of thanks to the people behind this show, particularly Angelica Rojas, Angelica Celedon, Tess Kamba, Guinefe Abdon, and Anthony David. I think I would like to begin this short intervention by thanking four people. First and foremost, Richard Hughes for accepting my suggestion to have this meeting in Chile. And Richard was very appreciative of this idea. The first meeting happened in Tunis in Africa, the second happened in Asia in Kuala Lumpur, and it was quite appropriate for us to have the third meeting in Latin America, and Chile was so chosen as a venue, and Rich was quite supportive of this idea. Equally so, I think Makeka, the Angelica Celedon, we call her Makeka, was very receptive to the idea of moving this meeting to Chile, so I want to thank her as well. Akhtar Baksha, the senior director of Microsoft, came forward with immediate funding possibilities, which also ensured that the meeting was going to happen in Chile, so thanks especially to Akhtar. And finally to Florencia Celeles, the senior program specialist at Telecentro.org, but the man who enabled Telecentro.org to come to this level of global attention. He has served as the chair of the program committee, so I'd like to thank him as well. So, it's my tradition usually to seize the opportunity at the inaugural session to thank the people behind the show, so forgive me for taking some 2-3 minutes of your time. Now, the theme of the meeting, and I should thank again Florencio for helping me to shape up the theme of this meeting, which is employability, productivity, empowerment at the crossroads. He was the first to appreciate the thought process, and in fact, he helped to shape up the entire theme. But having said that, I owe a lot to the participants here, because this topic involves at least four words, right? Employability, productivity, empowerment, grassroots. And all these four words would need to be understood in the current context. It's extremely important if we have a theme for a global forum, we understand the current context in which the world operates today. So what is the grassroots? Let me take the last word first. What is the grassroots? Now, different people would call grassroots different things. Initially, grassroots was an idea promoted in the United States from a political perspective, grassroots party, what they call it. It's the reflection of the soil. It grows from the soil. You know, that's the kind of connotation grassroots was given. But in today's context, we hear a lot of things. Base of the pyramid. C.K. Prahalad, who is no longer with us, he coined the term the bottom of the pyramid, which resonated to some extent the idea of the grassroots. The IT sector started calling the grassroots the emerging market. You know, until recently, the grassroots did not seem to be the market for many companies. But now there is a new connotation of emerging markets. Manuel Costas, in his trilogy of the information society, he understood the grassroots in the classification that he had in mind, the four worlds. Interestingly, the fourth world was a kind of a notorious world, which also formed part of the grassroots. DFID, the Department of International Development, in the context of actually nagging the Indian leadership, came up with a report called The Four Indias. And I would like to borrow from this idea of four Indias at the global context. I believe that there are four worlds in every country. There is a developed world within a particular country, there is a developing world within a particular country, a group of people who are aspiring to become rich and grow up the ladder of what they call the middle income to high middle income group. There is also a group called the poor world, the people who are the statistics for the MDG goals and MDG attention. The poverty alleviation agenda is actually driven by the fact that there is also a poor world within every nation. And finally, there is also a missing world. They are not even statistics. They are forgotten. They are people who live in abject poverty. If you get out of the airport in Cape Town, travel towards the mountainous region, you would find the contrast. On one hand, at the left-hand side, you would find people living in polythene bags. On the other hand, palatial homes. So you have also this missing world within every society. So how do we define the grassroots? Is it any longer the soil, the grown from the soil idea? The reshaping geographies is the title of the World Elephant Report 2009, which actually for the first time recognized that the grassroots is actually moving. Grassroots is no longer static. It's no longer confined to the soil. It's a movement. And we believe that every seventh person in this planet is a migrant. Every seventh person, that equals 1 billion people who don't live in the same place. And it's understood to be good. Now today in the current context, 1 billion people live in remote and lagging areas. 1 billion people live in world cities, in slums, not in good homes, but in slums. And 1 billion people who are supposedly poor. That's where the Millennium Development Goals are aiming to address, right? So the 3 billion people are in question today. And how do we understand that the grassroots is equally in question? So in the context of the next 3 days, we would like to have at the back of our mind that the grassroots is moving. Grassroots is actually not static. 35 million people in the United States change residence every year. They don't live in the same residence as they used to. And in fact, 8 million people change their states. And you can see the correlation between movement and the prosperity. Melville Dewey, who classified knowledge in the early 19th century, actually put, I know many of you who have been to libraries would understand that the books are classified under some number. So 380 is an interesting number in libraries. It's the number given for communication, for trade, for transport, for roads. So you can see the correlation between movement, the roads, transport, communication, and trade. 35% of the people, actually the economies within the Western Europe are trade among the neighbors. So the mantra today is no longer the status quo of the son of the soil or the grown from the soil idea of the grassroots. It's all about higher density population, people are moving to cities. It's all about shorter distances, and it's also equally about fewer divisions. 3% of Africans actually move out of their country, and it's detrimental. Today's research actually reveals that one of the reasons Africa is not progressing is because of the restrictions to the flow of ideas, flow of skills, flow of people, flow of goods and services. So I thank, I think, the United Nations Development Programme and the World Development Programme, interestingly, in the same year, in 2009, took up this topic of migration and the geographies that are actually seen in a new context. So